Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. This is Shrikant and today we will be posting solution to this problem of Java 1D array. It has been requested by a viewer. So let's start. What is an array? An array is a simple data structure used to store a collection of data in contiguous blocks of memory. Note that the elements are contiguous in the memory of the computer, that is the random access memory. And each element in the collection is accessed using an index. So each element can be randomly accessed, like you specify an index 1, what is the element at index 1 or index 2, whatever index you give, you will get the element at that position. So array is basically random access, not like some other collections such as say set or a hash map, which are not necessarily stored in contiguous blocks. Okay, so how an array is declared in Java? It is declared using the data type of the element followed by open bracket and close bracket, and then the array variable's name is equal to new and again the data type followed by the number of elements that you want to store. Note that this number of elements has to be defined at the compile time of the program, that is you cannot change it after in the middle during the runtime. Okay, so this sets aside a block of memory that is capable of storing 4 integers. Each integer storage cell is assigned a unique index ranging from 0 to 1 less than the size of the array, and each cell initially contains 0. So initially the default value that is contained in the array in case of integers will be 0. In case of my array, we can store integers at the indices 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, let's say we wanted the last cell to store the number 12. To do this, we will write my array of 3, that is 4 minus 1 3 is equal to 12 to do so. And to print the element in that index, we have to use system.out.println, which is in the java.lang header file. Okay, basically it is a namespace, so it will print every array element in the new line. Say it will going to print this element in the third position in a new line. Fine. So the rest of all you can read it yourself. So to start a program in Java, what we have to do is we have to create a class. Some of the portion of the code is already given. Like first of all, we have to import the Java u.util.star for taking input from the command line. Okay. In that there is a class called as scanner, which can be used to take input from the standard input, which is system.in. Okay, and every Java program starts with a class. Okay, public class and any name of the class, the public is not necessary. Okay, and then this is the standard main function which should be there in a class in case of a Java program if it has to be run by a command line, and that is declared by using public static void main followed by string of args. Okay, these are the command line parameters. So to get the elements from the standard input, here the input is given, there are 5 elements in the array, and we have to basically read the input from the command line, okay, from the input, standard input, and print it to standard output. Okay, so what we will do is, this portion of the code is already given. Scanner scans the input, okay, separated by spaces by default, okay, spaces or new lines. So first we will take the number of elements as input, that is 5, which is taken here, scanner dot next int. So this will fetch the next integer input from the input, that is standard input. Okay, so we have got the number of elements in the array. So now to declare the array, what we will do is that is already specified here, say int of my array is equal to new int 4. So we are basically given 5 elements, right? N is equal to 5. So what we will do is, to create this array, we will use, and the array should be named as A, because see, it is printing here sequentially the elements, and the array name it is using is A. Okay, A of I and A dot length. A dot length is the length of the array. So we have to declare the array with the variable name A is equal to new int of, the size of the array will be n, which in our case is 5 given as input. Okay, Now, to take the elements at each index 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, we can use the scanner to scan the next integers as long as the integers are present. Okay. So while i is equal to 0 and I less than n, that is the 5 elements that we have to scan. We will keep scanning these element and we have to keep putting in the corresponding index. So what we will do is a of I is equal to 12. So the element 10 will go in index 0, then I will be incremented. Okay, here after coming here, it will go to this place and increment I. They can again check the condition, I is still less than n, and then again it will scan the next input and so on to correspondingly get all the integers of the array, and then this line closes the scanner, okay, object, and then here we are going, it is printing all the elements one by one, okay, like this. Let's try to run the sample test case. Yeah, the standard test sample test case has passed. It's a very simple problem. Let's submit the code. So yeah, all the test cases have passed. Hope you enjoy watching this video and hope you got some valid information about how to write a program in Java. Thank you very much. Thanks for watching. Thank you.